join me responsively in the call to worship. Holy Trinity, source of all light, illuminate the darkness of our world. To the hearts of those gripped by sin, bring your light.
To those suffering depression or mental illness, bring your light.
To the souls enslaved by the ways of the world, bring your light.
To those gripped by anxiety and fear, bring your light.
To the hearts of those who mourn, bring your light.
To the souls of those who inflict pain, bring your light.
To those with no place to call home, bring your light.
To those intent on persecuting others in the name of God, bring your light.
To those with heavy choices ahead of them, bring your light.
To those in need, bring your light.
To those for whom this season does not bring joy but sorrow, bring your light.
To classrooms of despair, confusion, and falsehood, bring your light.
To the anger and violence in the world, bring your light.
To war-torn territories, bring your light.
To lands darkened, flooded, or destroyed by natural disasters, bring your light.
Wherever there is confusion, despair, loneliness, and anger, bring your light.
As our world descends into greater darkness, we can be confident that our advocate and Savior is with us. Please stand. As we come to our time this morning of pastoral prayer and the Lord's Prayer, I'd like to share with you some pastoral concerns that have happened in this past week in our congregation. On Friday evening, Nell Palmer died at the hospice center. Her memorial service will be scheduled this coming Saturday at 2 p.m. here in the sanctuary, and a reception in Pioneer Hall to follow. We also remember the family of Linda Braswell. Her service was on Thursday this past week after she died on Monday, as we remember her sons Steve and Casey and their families. We also want to lift up this morning Maggie Simmons Hughes, who's at Givens Estate in Black Mountain. She is in a rehab program there and will be returning home to us after she is fully recovered. Mildred Fletcher is at the rehab at College Pines, making very good progress. I got word yesterday that she's actually walking again, and so this is a major accomplishment for her since her left side was affected by the stroke. Rosalba Shook is someone I visited also this past week, and we want to remember her as she goes through some general health concerns that she's having, but she's been to the doctor just on Thursday evening or Thursday afternoon this week. Benji Peru is also recovering from a bout with the flu and lost his friend Linda Braswell, so we keep him in our prayers as well. Let us turn to God now as we pray together. Merciful and gracious God, we lift our voices with songs of praise and thanksgiving, with joyful notes as we hear our new organ for the first time, with an opportunity in our hearts to be able to say thank you for the many good blessings that you've given us throughout our lives, and particularly throughout this year. We thank you, God, for the assurance that we have of our relationship in Christ, who came to be with us in human form, a form that we celebrate this day, acknowledging his birth and his life amongst us and his many teachings that help us to become far better human beings than we could without it. So we ask, O Lord, your guiding spirit, that Holy Spirit that he gave to us after he was resurrected and returned to you, to continue to be our guiding source of life as we live expectantly with hope and with joy in our hearts. We thank you, God, for your blessings of love in our lives, for bodies that heal from infirmities and strokes, for your guiding spirit that helps to bring comfort to those who mourn. And we remember particularly this day the family of Linda and also the family of Nell, as they have just recently lost their loved one. Guide and strengthen those families and others, O God, that go through grief, especially in this special time of the year, in which most people are joy-filled, but some are struggling with loss and despair in their lives. Bring comfort, O God, to those people, and help us to reach out to them in meaningful ways in our own lives. We ask, O God, your blessing of love to be with our sister congregation in Guatemala this day as we celebrate with them the relationship that we have with you. So they are celebrating the birth of Christ and are looking for his coming into their lives as well. We ask, O Lord, your blessing in the ministries that this church has in Malawi and the work that we do there with the Children's Hospital. Guide and strengthen us in all of our service and all of our outreach, both here at home and afar, as we continue in our faithfulness of being Christ-like to the world. We ask, O God, now that as we celebrate again, as we remember again the birth of Christ, that it become fresh and new in each of our hearts, and that we lift ourselves with gratitude and thanksgiving for all you have provided. For it's in Christ who taught us how to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us
As the early Christians met and broke bread together in token of their fellowship and love, so the members of the Moravian church family make it a custom to celebrate spiritual occasions by sharing with friends a simple meal called the Love Feast. Food and drink for the Love Feast vary with the nationality and the location of the congregation. First Moravian Love Feast occurred in Waldensian, Germany in 1727. The Love Feast is a translation of the Greek word agape, given by Christians after Pentecost to similar gatherings. The Love Feast, where the symbolism is that of Christians sharing with one another, is not a substitute for the Holy Communion, where the teaching is that God shares with man. The Love Feast strengthens the spirit of the community, goodwill, and unity among people. At least for the time of this service, all social barriers and distractions are set aside. This is a service of joy, dignified by reverence. You are asked to partake of the Love Feast in the belief that Christ is now beside you. Covenant with him and receive a new Christ.
Those who are seated in the center of each aisle to begin passing the cups down until the last person on the aisle is served, and then back up until the first person is served. So everyone will be served in the aisle. Later in the program, during the offertory, the servers will retrieve the cups. Please put your napkin and any extra trash that you have inside of the cup, and then they will receive them at that time. Now let us prepare ourselves for the blessing. Let us pray. Come, Lord Jesus, our guest to be, and bless these gifts bestowed by thee. Bless thy dear ones everywhere, and keep them in thy loving care. Amen. Also, I invite you to remain seated as we sing this next carol as you receive these items.
Thank you.
with each other. You have commissioned us to go and love and to share that love with this world. So we ask that you use our gifts and use our lives for the building of your kingdom and the promise of your glory in Jesus Christ. For it's in his name we pray. Amen. Please be seated.
The word that Isaiah the son of Amos saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. And it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established in the top of the mountains, and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow unto it. And many people shall go and say, Come ye, and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. And he will teach us of his ways, and we will walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth the law, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. And he shall judge among the nations, and shall rebuke many people. And they shall beat their swords and plowshares, and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore. O house of Jacob, come ye, and let us walk in the light of the Lord. Arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. But the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee. And the Gentiles shall come to thy light, and the kings to the brightness of thy rising. Now it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And that taxing first took place when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to his own city to be taxed. So Joseph went up from Nazareth out of Galilee into Judea to the city of Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, with Mary, his espoused wife, who was great with child. And it happened that while she was there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in that same country shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were so afraid. But the angel said, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be his sign to you: you shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger."
Thank you. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known to us. And they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning the child. And all they that heard it wondered at these things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all the things they heard and seen as it was told unto them. Little child, whose bed is straw, take new lodgings in my heart. Bring the dream Isaiah saw, life redeemed from fang and claw.
Thank you.
us pray. Holy and merciful God, from prophetic vision to human life, you came to be with us in a form that we would understand. You came to be with us that we may know to find the way to true life. We give you thanks, O God, with voices of praise, with songs in our hearts, with spirits of joy as we go from this place. We ask your blessing now upon our lives as we continue in our worship and our praise of you. In Jesus' holy name. Express our thanks with an applause. go forward from here with peace. Let that peace reign in your hearts, for the world needs it desperately. May grace, power, and peace live in each of our lives, not only this holy season as we prepare for Christmas, but throughout our lives. In Jesus' holy name, amen.